Hello, it's LMTX. Today I will present a simple serverless IoT architecture. Serverless is a popular design concept for cloud applications, but it's not always obvious that it can be used in IoT deployments. I will show a sample design of a system with three thermometers and a fan illustrating the air conditioning device. Those connected devices have very limited capabilities. Thermometers are able to send readings to the cloud, and fan is able to receive readings from the cloud. Before we start the actual implementation, we need to define the MQTT topics used in our system. Let's review assumptions. Our system can be used by multiple users. Every user can define multiple rooms. User can install multiple thermometers in every room and single air conditioning device. This is extremely simplified example, but it presents the approach that can be extended in real-life scenario. The MQTT topic structure for thermometers looks as follows. We've got user ID, in our case that is user ABC, room ID, in our case room 1, temp, which is the restricted level for thermometers, and temp ID, temp 1, temp 2, or 3. Fan will use following topic structure. We've got the user ID, user ABC in our case, the room ID, room 1, and fan, which is the restricted level for fan assigned to this room. Now let's briefly cover the MQTT QoS. The MQTT QoS, quality of service level, is an agreement between sender of a message, for instance a thermometer, and receiver of a message, for instance IoT Core. It defines the guarantee of delivery for a specific message. There are three quality of service levels defined for MQTT. 0, the message is going to be delivered at most once. 1, the message will be delivered at least once, so we might have duplicates. And 2, that means the message is going to be delivered exactly once. A typical approach when defining the MQTT QoS is following. For non-critical messages, we should use the quality of service 0. For critical messages, we need to use the quality of service 1 or 2. We need a guarantee that the message will be delivered. The temperature readings are frequently sent from thermometers to AWS, and that is not a critical data. So we will use quality of service 0. But the fan control messages are important. We want fan to be turned on and off when needed. That's why we will use the quality of service 1. There are many ways to implement the logic of our system. I recommend using the IoT rules. The overall concept is as follows. Thermometers are sending data to IoT Core. IoT Core is using rules to verify if temperature is higher or lower than maximum or minimum. If that is the case, it will turn the fan on and off. If temperature is between min and max, it will not change the state of our fan. Now, let's switch to AWS console and proceed with actual deployment. We need to go to the IoT Core service. Let's use search functionality for it. Now, we go to the Act. Rules and create a new rule. We need to give a rule a name, fan on, description that we want this fan to be turned on once a temperature is above 25 degrees. Now we need to define the rule query statement. We want to query data from the topic user ABC, room 1, temp, we add plus at the end because we want to gather data from all thermometers, and we want to filter only messages where temperature is higher than 25 degrees. If that is the case, we want to send the on message representing the state of our fan. We need to add the action and the action is going to be actually to republish the message to topic used by Fan. The topic is the user ABC, room 1, Fan. We will use the quality of service 1 because we want to be sure that the message is going to be delivered. Now we need to select a role used by IoT Core to publish message to specific topic. And create a rule. The same way we need to create a rule to turn the fan off. The fan should be turned off once the temperature is below 20 degrees. We need to define the rule query statement. So, as before, we will query messages on the user ABC, room 1, temp plus, because we want to get data from all thermometers, where temperature is lower than 20 degrees. If that is the case, we'll send the message off as state. And we define the role action. So the message is going to be actually sent to the specified MQTT topic. We will send our message to topic used by Fan. So it's user ABC, room 1, Fan. We will use the quality of service 1 because we want to be sure that the message is going to be delivered. Once again, we are picking the IAM rule and creating our rule. Okay, so we are ready to run a test. Let's use the built-in MQTT test client and open it into two browser windows. The left-hand side window is going to represent our thermometer. On right, we will have our fan. For convenience, we will subscribe to the topics used by our thermometers. That will show the messages sent from thermometers to the IoT Core. On the right, we will subscribe to the topic used by our fan to see if fan is receiving the control messages from the IoT Core. Now we are ready to publish our first message. Let's use thermometer 1 as an example. Change message payload to the temp. And let's use 26 degrees. We will use the quality of service 0 as we agreed before. And let's publish our message. As you can see, the message was published from the thermometer to the cloud and IoT Core used rules to republish it to the fan topic with state on. Temperature is higher than the maximum level. Now let's publish the temperature readings of 23. 23 is between min and max temperature, so IoT rule will not change the state of a fan. As a final test, let's publish temperature 19. 19 is below our min temperature, so IoT rule will trigger the state off for our fan, because the temperature is below the minimum. In this short video, we covered many important things. The MQTT topic structure design, the MQTT quality of service levels, AWS IoT rules, and AWS IoT MQTT test client. This is a very simple example, but presents the real solution architecture. The serverless design ensures that our IoT system will scale to meet required load, without any changes in deployed infrastructure. I hope that was interesting for you. All the best, LNTX.